got tissue.
Come on, Barney.
Who else is going to walk box?
Look, look. Why don't I just put it down over here, right? That means I've got to turn all the way around and bend and all. See?
Oh, Thomas, please.
Oh, I'd love to, Sam, but I've got a dash.
Oh, please, so have I.
Oh, right. Where to?
Oh, the coffee bar.
Right.
Thanks so much.
That's it. Oh, no, Sam. Oi! I've got a bit of a problem. Sam! Oh.
Mr. Jim?
Yeah, that's right.
Always try and avoid stress in your life.
Put me down for a dozen, will you? Where's Mr. Braithwaite?
Week off, caravanning in Rill.
Oh.
Sunil Gupta, your temporary case officer.
Oh, thank you.
So, how's the outside world treating you, Thomas?
Look at that. Sight for sore eyes.
£20.
Maybe next time, Reggie.
Wait a minute.
Hello?
Yeah, we're going to get back to you. Yeah, I've got an E-Reg Ford Granada. Pageant Blue. Yeah, Pageant. Well, it's one down from Sky and one up from Royal. Look, it's here if you want it. All right, good. See you tomorrow.
Right, Lively. 40. Done.
I see you've got a job at a steam museum. That's very good.
It's not really a job as such. I mean, I'm on a month's trial, you know?
It's better than most people I meet. Most people come out with nothing, get nothing, and go back inside because there is nothing.
Well, that rules me out, doesn't it? I lost my flat, my business, and some bastard ran off with my woman. Apart from that, everything's hunky-dory.
I know this is a square one, but it won't always be. This job of yours, part-time?
Yeah, why? Yeah.
Need to keep you off the street. We've got this scheme going for young offenders.
Well, thanks for the compliment.
No, Thomas, you're not on it. You're taking it. I want you to teach car maintenance.
Teach? Me? No. No, I've never taught anybody anything in my life.
Build, Thomas.
Yeah, look, I don't know how.
Build.
When?
Tomorrow.
Excuse me, would you mind? I have a meeting at 3. Thank you. Thomas.
Yeah, Franklin, you ever done any teaching?
Those that can do, those that can't teach. I can, I do.
What about those who won't?
Oh, they will. Even if I have to take them there myself.
I've got a school party at 10, the tourist board at 11, and a heritage meeting at 12. It's an extremely heavy day. I need you.
There's nothing I can do about it.
Oh, Thomas, you've only been here a week and already you want time off.
No, it's not time off exactly. I just can't do mornings.
Look, if you've got another job, why don't you just come out and say it? Who's your new employer? Anyone I know?
Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II.
It's part of her little plan to keep me out of mischief.
I should have realised, I'm sorry. I wouldn't have thought you were the mischief-making kind.
Well, that depends what sort of mischief you're talking about. No chance of us going to the pictures, is there?
Yes, no chance. I've got a quarterly review to finish. Besides, you look like the octopus type to me. All hands, no popcorn.
Would I?
Yes.
Would you?
Who knows?
How many balls will the clutch place?
I won't need to know that.
There's always one smart ass in every class.
Three.
Bloody typical. Me, I work hard on the stall all day. I come home knackered. And the last thing I need to find is that you have nipped all the hot water.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah, well, think next time, eh?
Yeah, all right. Watcher.
So this is your humble abode?
And I did this shopping for you today.
Bad timing, eh?
No, no. Perfect.
Go easy on the man, will you?
If you'd ask me, he's got it too easy.
Look, I know it's very confined here with three people, but he's a friend. You've got to have give and take.
Yeah. We give, he takes.
Game of pool? I wouldn't have thought that was your scene, frankly.
Thanks. And what is my scene?
Oh, I don't know. Silk pyjamas and a stuffed olive.
You see, you couldn't be more wrong. I'm like you, Thomas. I like the simple pleasures in life.
Like being chauffeured and having your egg boiled. Come on, Franklin. You're not someone who does anything for nothing. What do you want?
True. I came here because I wanted us to stay in touch. Yes? I mean, I think we could be useful to each other.
Me? Useful to you?
Well, you see, the thing is...
Yeah?
Well, I was hoping that,
What?
That you might know a decent fish and chip shop.
Lively have got me driving test!
Good morning. Morning, boys.
Learning.
You're just gonna have to give me a crash course, aren't you?
No way. What became of your driving lesson?
Oh, get lost. I'm not gonna pay some pervert 25 quid to twit me gear stick and touch me knee. Oh, please, Lively, I'll do anything for you.
Get off, woman.
Oh, go on, you know you love me,
you
really.
I'll see you later, all right? Women on your legs. It's the latest thing.
Oh, go on, Lively.
Good luck, by the way.
You still owe me 10 quid for the shopping. Oh, please.
Oh, all right, then. Come on. Talk.
Do what? You talking to me?
Are you the new chap?
Yeah, that's right. Thomas Gynn.
Robin. I run this team.
Oh, yeah?
Ever worked with kids before?
No. Well, I was one once.
Well, every little helps in this game. What banter?
Oh, no, thanks.
You'll love working with kids. Cheesy biscuit?
No, thanks. Well, I have to teach them, then.
Try and teach them to switch right off. Try and be mates. Gain their confidence.
Inspire.
Enhance. You'll have no trouble.
Yeah, hold on. What am I supposed to inspire them to do then?
You're going to rebuild our stock car. Belter.
Come on, give it me back. It's not yours.
Oh, don't mess around, lad. Come on. Oh.
Who wants his chuff chuff then?
Boy. All right, boys. This is Thomas. Well, I'll leave you to it. I've got a Belgian camping trip to organise. Inspire away. Anyone seen a football last night? Don't like football, eh? All right, tell me, what do you know about cars, then?
And we stopped.
Maybe I was overconfident in your ability.
There's nothing wrong with my ability. Which one's reverse?
Oh, let's have a look here. Well, now the first thing we need to do here is drain the oil. So I need my spanner. Give us my spanner, will you?
Me ask for me spanner.
Now let's get one thing straight. Nobody touches my tools unless I say so, right? Right?
Right.
Now has anything else gone walkabout? Or do I have to search?
How's it going then?
Steam museum, please, if that's not too much to ask.
Bug off.
Look, I've got a living to earn, pal. Don't waste my time if you can't pay the market rate. All the 200 was last week.
It's not me, it's the frigging clutch.
Well, I managed perfectly well.
Oh, well, you're the bloody hero.
So he says to me, inspire them, Thomas. Be their friend. They need love. What a load of crap. I need a good kick up the arse.
Drop that, and I'll dock your wages.
You make me wages, I'm worried about losing. Come on. What the...
Daft cow. Me? I was trying to avoid you.
You hardly squeeze for room, are you? Come on, blimey, get the QE2 through there.
Oh, Jesus.
Stupid place to park a car, though.
It's brand new.
Look, are you sure it wasn't a little bit dented before?
Oh, what about my no-claims bonus?
Oh, don't swear at me. What about my van?
Well, personally, I don't give a toss about your van.
Oh, that's damn near fighting.
All right, all right, all right. Let's all calm down, shall we?
If I'd have known you were Thomas's fancy woman, I'd have rammed you even harder. Oh,
that's enough, thank you.
Boy, keep your nose out, you cockney git. Never made a mistake in his life,
then. Oh, for God's sake, you told.
Oh, look, I think the best thing we can do is to swap insurance details.
Yeah, that's the answer, yeah.
Yeah, well, of course, I mean, I have insurance myself.
Oh, I don't believe that.
Look, don't worry about the car. I can mend that.
Come on. Well, that's some of the dents banged out.
do you think you could hang these up?
I'll leave me clothes wherever I like and you can keep your sniding trap shut. 5 minutes you've been here and you reckon you'll own the place.
Yeah, what's all this?
You can shut it as well. Who do you think you are, eh? What makes you so special? I'll tell you what, nothing. Zilch. You're a ponce. Poncing Thomas.
All right, Pippa.
Don't know what Sally ever saw in you. You're a class A loser. Best thing she ever did, getting out before you dragged her down to your level. Look at you now. 45 years old, nothing to your name, dossing down in a shithole like this, and chasing after the first tart you lay your eyes on.
Pippa!
Hey, I'm coming, I'm coming.
Hey. Room in your bed for a little one.
When do you want me out then?
I don't want you out.
Well, tomorrow, day after.
Never look.
Nah, it's best. I'm just in the way.
Nobody wants you out. Pippa was just.
Yeah, Pippa's got nothing to do with it. When?
You sure?
Yeah. Nah, it's time to move on, mate. If I get a place of my own, it means I'm gonna have to make things happen. It's too easy staying with you.
You're not thinking of going back to the smoke, are you?
Never know.
Your family, Thomas. I'll keep an ear out. Promise me one thing, Thomas Gynn. You're not leaving here until you have a place to move into. There's enough flotsam and jetsam out there as it is.
Don't take offence, Robin. I mistrust everyone equally.
All right, Reg, here we go. Hello, Robin. Didn't think this was your neck of the woods.
Oh, you'd be surprised, Thomas. A few spares for Bertha. Settle the old account. Besides that, Reggie and me share a morbid interest in bacon sandwiches.
Here, and give me 20 quid so much.
Gee. Listen, actually, I wanted to talk to you anyway. I'm repairing a friend of mine's car, you know, and I haven't got the space. I was just wondering if...
Well, use the workshop?
Yeah.
Yeah, great idea.
You sure?
Use the boys, too. It'd be a good idea for them to work on something they're not going to smash up 5 minutes later.
With the dynamite. All right. Yeah, how much are you, Rich?
Oh, that for it?
Yeah.
Go on, I've got those.
No, don't be silly.
Go on, Reggie, put these on my account.
Sound. Fair enough.
Try the Canadian sweet cure next time.
Cheers.
What are you doing?
Thinking.
There's plenty of room for that in bed.
I like gardens.
Well, this isn't a garden. It's a plague of tetanus waiting to escape.
I never had a garden before. Why do you like me, Alex?
Pip, it's too heavy for this time in the morning.
I was horrible to him. I'm horrible to everybody.
You're not horrible to me.
Give me time.
Thomas is a big boy, Pip. I mean, he's not likely to go leaping off bridges.
You don't know Thomas.
I had a talk with Cyril the Fish. He has a room over the shop if you're interested.
What's it smell like?
After a couple of months, you wouldn't even notice it.
Nah. No, not that desperate.
Anyway, I don't see why you have to mow out at all. I mean, we're friends. We should be like the Three Musketeers.
Nah.
Why can't you wait till you settle down a bit more? If it's Pippa, she spends a lot of time over in Alex's.
I have got to go.
Well, so long as it's not London.
What's wrong with the smoke?
Too many bloody Londoners there for my liking.
Well, get out of it, really, on your bike yourself. Need the car in now.
You've seen too many James Dean films, son.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Captain O'Connor and her crew would like to welcome you aboard this WH many thousand. We'll be cruising at a height of 2 foot 6, and reaching a speed of 30 miles an hour.
You don't have to do this, you know.
In-flight extra strong winds are provided, and for those of you who haven't flown with us before...
What?
Sick bags are not provided.
There you go. Well, get on with it.
Get on with what?
You, my son, are mending that car. Have fun.
Oh. All right, Thomas.
Yeah, not bad, not bad. I've got them rebuilding the car and it's just a quick respray.
Oh, brilliant.
Don't fancy helping me out under canvas in Belgium, do you? You get good patty over there and as many chockies as you can stuff down your gullet.
No, thanks. I'm watching the weight.
Yeah, so am I. You're the first one that's made any impact, you know? The rest gave this up as a bad job. You're a natural for this game.
You never know. 60 grand a year, maybe I'll take it up as a career.
You don't go into this job for the money.
You haven't done too badly out of it, have you?
This? It's a birthday present.
She must really love you.
Mothers are like that, aren't they?
There. Didn't hurt, did it?
Hey, Thomas! You left your wrench out!
Beginning to get on my nerves! Keep out with this!
That's it for me for the day.
Lift?
Yeah, that'd be handy, yeah.
God, wait!
Teachers, well, put out your Speedy!
No. Oh, dear, Speedy, what have you done?
Hold on, hold on. Forgot me wrench.
You seem to have a very bad twitch, Speedy. Bloody hell's going on here? Get off him! All right, son.
Oh, Thomas!
Come on, son. Oh, man, you've been inside. Are we in for the parking ticket?
No, son. Manslaughter.
Thomas! Thomas, outside.
Listen, there's something you ought to know.
What the hell are you up to? What are you trying to achieve? Violence solves nothing. This was supposed to be a partnership, two equal halves. So what was it about, eh?
Doesn't matter.
Yes, it does. A grown man doesn't threaten a 17-year-old boy with a monkey wrench for nothing.
He smashed the lights.
The lights? A bit of glass and a bit of metal.
It's going to look good on a probation report, isn't it?
All right, it's not just the lights, you know. Ah, forget it.
Right? Like this.
What for?
The damage.
I don't want your money. Stuff your money.
Right. You all right?
I couldn't do nothing, Thomas. I shouldn't be on this course.
Join the club.
I was down for community service, doing an old lady's garden, but there was a bit of a cock-up.
Yeah?
She died on the first morning.
Have a nice day, boys.
I thought we had a deal.
Look at this place. Look at the views. Call yourself estate agents. You couldn't sell air to a paper bag. Look, ensuite bathrooms, air conditioning, the finest craftsmanship that Leeds can muster. Now, when I develop a site, I don't do it for a hobby, I do it to make money. Flats are built to be lived in by people, not to play host to a few dead moths and a couple of dust mites.
But Mr. Bysouth, there's a recession on.
What did he say?
There's a recession on.
Look, Sonny, don't tell me there's a recession on. I read about it in the Nick. Now, you advertise this as a top floor flat. I distinctly told you to advertise it as a penthouse, and that is not a balcony, it is a roof terrace.
Sorry, Mr. Bysouth.
Sorry.
Now, in a recession, only the best survive.
Yes, Mr. Bysouth.
Yes, Mr. Bysouth.
Yes, Mr. Bysouth. Good. You're fired.
I've got another one. Just like it.
No, just looking. I could do you a good deal. We're rationalising our capital investments. That's flogging off some of the old boats to you and me. This one was a peak, though. Only one lady owner.
Yeah, I know.
You knew Mrs. Hardcastle, then?
Oh, yeah, I knew.
Sorry.
How are you?
Lively says you're going.
Yep, that's right.
Thomas, I didn't mean it. It was just me and me big mouth. Don't code, please.
No, I've got to, Pips.
I'll cook you breakfast for a month. I'll do your washing for a year. I'll hang your newspapers. But, Thomas, please don't go because of me.
Oi, oi, oi. I'm not going because of you. I'm going. Well, I just have to for me. But don't you think I know when your mouth's working time and half?
Yeah, but I always seem to drive people away.
No, you don't.
Look, I got you this.
What? Come here.
Come in, number four. Your time is up.
I hate fitness.
Yeah, it was that extra portion of chips, wasn't it?
Please, Thomas, that's a secret between you, me, and my waistline. Look, if you needed a flat, why haven't you said?
Well, I didn't know until now, did I?
Well, I'm sure I can fix it up. I mean, we seem to have a glut of unsold properties at the moment.
Yeah, but I want to pay the going rate.
Of course.
And nothing too yuppie. I mean, I don't know, a duvet from a bidet.
Well, I'm not going to change your sheets then, am I? Oh,
Franklin. Yeah, well done, team. Well, let's see if it works, shall we?
Can I try it?
Yeah, sure, yeah. I'll go easy, all right. Don't tell me. That's why they call you Speedy.
How'd you guess? Seems all right.
Can I run it back to your friend?
No, thank you. I'll drive.
Well, I'm afraid you've missed him. He's with the young scallywag.
I know. It wasn't him I came to see.
Excuse the mess. It's the bottler's day off. Why should a man of your entrepreneurial bent be concerned about our Thomas?
Well, he's a rare breed, Lively. He's also the most honest man I've met. An earthy romantic.
There's nothing wrong with that.
I know. But it's the romance that gets us into trouble. He's no front. He has no veneer. What you see is what you get. There's no Machiavellian instinct abroad in Thomas.
He's vulnerable.
Exactly.
You know he wants to move out?
Yes, he told me.
I don't blame him. Three people here is like sharing a cell. Well, I just want to make sure he doesn't do anything rash.
Rash?
Well, he gets this urge to do things for himself, to make things happen. It's harder than he thought it would be. He's thinking of going back to London.
Wasn't there trouble in London?
Oh, yeah. That's why he ran away up here in the first case. Sally was his reason for staying here. No.
He needs a new anchor.
Oh, wow! You never said we were coming here.
No, I thought I'd give you a surprise.
Sit up, bloke lying down. His name's Barnett. You're nice to him, he'll show you around.
Right. Does it go?
Oh, aye. She's a full working model.
Here, Barney. Don't let him drive.
Very impressive. I was expecting something straight out of Blue Peter. All that glue and sticky-back plastic.
Oh, careful. You're talking to a professional, you know.
So you can mend things, after all.
Try me hand at most things.
Do you know? All your own work?
No, I did have some help.
How much?
What?
Money. How much do I owe you?
No. Forget that. All the parts were free.
Thomas, I can't let you do all this work for nothing.
What have you got in mind?
Pictures?
Nah. I'm busy. Besides, you seem like the octopus type.
We have two choices. Arnold Schwarzenegger or Woody Allen?
Well, I don't know about you. I fancy a bit of Barney myself.
Oh, really? Any particular bit?
What sign has a white circle, red engine, and a car and a motorcycle in the middle?
Prohibit access to cars and motorcycles.
Will you shut up, you? It's my test.
Sorry.
Enjoy that.
Yes, I did enjoy it.
Yeah. I enjoy it. No,
Hasta la vista, baby.
That's a joke, really, if you think about it, because that bloke could... You all right?
No. My car's been stolen.
Oh, what?
Oh, no. Marvellous. Suppose we ought to get a cab.
Yeah, the only thing is, I
That'll teach him, won't it? What's the matter with you laughing, boy?
Don't like it. Don't like nicking cars from people we know.
Oh, don't come all songs of praise to me.
He's gonna be looking for it.
It's not his. It's that bird's.
But we know whose it is.
So we've deviated. We shifted it. We shifted the others. New plate, it's a scrap log book. We're looking at a quick £3,000.
Don't like it.
You'll just have to bloody lump it. Has he let us down yet? Has he?
£1,000 a month.
Plus maintenance. I mean, that's the market rent.
What'd you sit on?
Well, it's unfurnished.
Let me see that. Yeah, it's nice, isn't it?
Mm.
No, I'm sorry, Franklin. I should never have asked.
Well, look, I've got one at 12 the quadrant.
Nah. I mean, have you got anything that's more sort of mean?
Thomas, I'm a property developer. I'm not a slum landlord.
Don't you have to be elsewhere?
Well, by rights, yeah, but I was concerned. No news, then?
No, no news. The car is probably lying burnt out in some old riverbed by now.
Oh, that'd be good, wouldn't it? I mean, that means it's definitely been nicked, so the insurance will have to cough up with the full Monty, and bingo, new motor.
You have a perverse way of looking at things.
Yeah, and if it's just a few little dents, then yours truly can always...
Thomas, it was your friends who, without any insurance, drove into my car.
Oh, yeah, but they're covered now, you know.
I am with you, and my car is stolen.
Mm-hmm.
You're a walking disaster area. Look, right now, at this very moment in time, I suggest you don't come anywhere near me.
You don't happen to know of any flats going, do you?
Well, well, well. Franklin Bicep.
George. Have you got a moment? See, you did well.
I got a good price. Luckily, you weren't around to outbid me for it.
I'm afraid I was unavoidably detained.
I thought about you at nights. Having nightmares, drooling at the mouth, having missed a cracking waterfront site this side of the A1.
That's what I like about you, George. Such concern for your fellow man. So what will you do then? Raise it to the ground and whop up some new flats or a warehouse?
No, 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 frankly, no. The world has moved on. Gone are the days when you would knock down a bloody good Victorian warehouse, only to build a brand new imitation one with pink balconies. No, restoration's the name of the game. Small units. Some residential, some business. Anyway, why are you so interested? Are you thinking of buying me out or something, huh?
Not exactly. No.
New car?
No, flat.
Well, use the phone if you need to.
Oh, cheers. Listen, the way things are going, I'll end up nicking one of your tents.
Maybe next time, eh, lads?
Yeah.
All the equipment safe and sound in there?
Ship shape in Bristol.
Good. I'll see you later.
Ford Escort Cabriolet, you say? Well, I've got one here for a white D-ledge. So you'd have to do a respray.
No, no, no. You need new plugs, mate. Have you got any?
Oh, I'll have a gander over here. Yeah.
Tell you what, it's some property, this, isn't it? I've got some room. What's Robin use that other workshop for?
Don't know. Haven't been in. Camping stuff, I think. Hey, there might be some in that tool chest.
Plug it in. Oh dear, oh dear.
What's up?
Logbooks.
So?
Well, what are they doing here?
Well, they belong to the old wrecks we do up.
Yeah, yeah. And I'm a Dutch uncle. Look, Mercedes, BMW, Granada.
I don't know then.
Well, I do. And that is no camping store.
And don't worry if you fail. I mean, all the best people fail the first time.
Thanks.
Okay, you got everything. You got your license?
Yes.
Oi.
Don't worry. You'll be fine.
Do you,
you want me to try?
I shouldn't be doing this.
Why not? We're only gonna have a look.
Oh, come on.
Stupid, poxy, crappy, useless.
Oi! Stop it.
We'll get you there, don't worry.
I could get thrown back inside for this.
Don't be daft. Robin only sees the best in people.
Bloody hell.
How did that get here? We only gave it back to her yesterday.
Grow up, Speedy.
But if you nick a car, right, you haven't got the logbook, so how can you sell it?
It's called ringing. You buy a logbook of a scrap car, right, the same year, colour and make of one you've already nicked. Then you change the number plates to suit the logbook. I mean, the big boys change the engine number as well, but most people don't check on that anymore. And if they do, just say you've got a new engine. No keys, we're going to have to push it out of here.
Oh, don't be silly. Move over.
Oh, terrific. Now we're nicking a nick motor.
Just like that. We'll open the doors then.
Oh, and slowly this time. Go.
What are you playing at?
That's a good front, Robin. Certainly had me fooled.
Hey, shall I call the police?
What's the point? Who are they going to believe, eh? You and me? Or a middle-class Guardian reading youth worker?
Those keys were at my desk. All you had to do was ask.
What the...
Where did they come from?
Should be worth a few, Bob. Just about enough to buy yourself a new BMW, eh?
You don't know anything about this, do you?
And next time, don't get your boys to nick a friend of mine's car. Oh dear, what have I done? So how much do you pay, am I?
Who?
Dastardly and Muttley, that's who.
Pay them for what?
For what?
Nicking cars, that's for what? You set the whole thing up, didn't you?
Listen,
You were seen paying those two off.
When?
Earlier.
I was returning their deposits.
The deposits for what?
For the camping trip I cancelled this morning.
You bastard, have a look at third party.
You son, come back here. Come back here, I trusted you. I'll make sure you get 5 years first. My mum bought me that
camp. Rule of youth work.
You kick me, you dusty me.
No violets.
Thomas! Oi! Thomas, get the police! Thomas!
Loading limited to the restricted times. And this? Prohibited access for cars and motorcycles. I passed! What are you doing?
Moving out.
Already?
Mm-hmm. Coming, Thomas!
Yeah, okay.
But you can't, Lively! Tell him he can't!
It'll be all right.
But you can't. Today. I'll tell him.
Well, I ain't going far.
Through here, please. Thank you. And just over there. Thanks.
Here.
Yeah, it's great, isn't it?
Now, would you like the bed there, Thomas, or would you prefer it with a nice view of the gasworks?
No, I'll live without the view. Leave it there.
Okay, sofa, thanks, boys.
That's the one.
I hate you, Thomas.
I hate you and all. Give us a beer.
Very nice.
Well, hello. I'm sorry, we're clean out of coffee.
I thought I'd come and see the monster's pit. This is for you.
Oh. Ooh. Hey, look at this, look. Housewarming present. It's the first one I've ever had.
Canal. Water. Ship. Pathetic, isn't it?
No, I think that's smashing. Whoa, look at that. That goes in pride of place. There you go.
How'd you find this?
Oh, I didn't. Franklin knew someone.
So where do you want the sofa?
Sofa? I'll tell you what, put it over there, will it? I'm sorry, Sam.
Don't tell me. You'll mend it?
It's an offer he can't refuse.
I'm on the scotch. Come in and take your clothes off.
Stay lucky.